It's the middle of the school day, and the sixth grade teacher is riding a motorcycle. The reason Timothy Olmsted is not in school is complex, and according to many, deeply disturbing. 12-year-old Alicia Jones was one of his students.
He separated me from the white kids and set me to the other side of the room where all the black kids were.
Timothy Olmsted is accused by students and their families of taking black children and disabled children at the Heights Community School in St. Paul, Minnesota, and segregating them from white children. Melissa Dobbs was also a student in the class.
So what did you think when he put you and the other black children in the back of the room? What did it make you think about yourself?
Like I wasn't smart enough, or I'm not good enough for me to be with the other children, the other white children.
The children say at first they were afraid to tell their parents and grandparents, but they ultimately did, after they say they were repeatedly called stupid, sloppy, and disgusting.
Why do you think he was so mean to you?
Because we was black and he was white.
And it's not just students and relatives who are speaking out about Olmsted.
Do you work at the same school where Timothy Olmsted worked?
I do.
Jennifer Couture is a teacher who substituted for the class one day when Olmsted was out. She worries school administrators might punish her for speaking to us about him, but backs up what these children told us.
When you took over his class,
right,
were the black students segregated from the rest of the class?
Yes, as were the special ed students.
So special ed students and the black students were not sitting with the white students?
No.
The children, the parents, and other teachers say the bizarre abusive behavior lasted for months. Finally, after continuing complaints, Olmsted was placed on leave this past January. And then 2 months later, he resigned. But get this, he's still getting paid.
The St. Paul School District says he's owed back sick pay. All of this has caused a great deal of anger. The three children we talked with and their relatives have filed a civil suit against Olmsted and the St. Paul Public Schools, who they say knew about his actions for months and did nothing. The superintendent of schools denied to us in a written statement that the district ignored the complaints. We promptly investigated. We responded appropriately. And we intend to vigorously defend the lawsuit.
I think the behavior.
But the lawyer representing the children and parents disagrees, saying the school put protecting its reputation above protecting its children.
They'd rather sweep it under the rug than deal with it, and that's exactly what happened in this case.
And then there is this. Documents from the school district indicate Olmsted was reprimanded back in 2011 for sexually offensive behavior toward a female coworker at a holiday party. And in 2003, he was suspended for 5 workdays for making sexually offensive and inappropriate references to school children. In the disciplinary letter to Olmsted, the former superintendent stated, "For no discernible appropriate instructional reason, you digressed to describe some of your experiences of life on a farm and gave the class a graphic description of castrating horses and throwing their testicles into the field for cats to eat."
Despite the fact that the allegations against Olmsted in the past were excessively disturbing, the St. Paul School District continued to welcome children into its class year after year without ever telling parents a thing.
So we wanted to see what Olmsted, who still has a teaching certificate, had to say. He happened to be talking to a cop when we came up to him.
Mr. Olmsted? Yeah. My name is Gary Tuchman with CNN. I want to ask you about what happened in your classroom. Do you have any comments about that?
I have no comments.
Okay. I mean, there are allegations you separated the black children from the rest of the children in the classroom.
No comment.
And in 2003 and 2011, reports about you assaulting a fellow employee, saying inappropriate things to other students. What do you have to say about
that? No comment.
Well, did you do it or not? Just be honest with me.
No comment.
Okay. And why are you still collecting a salary from the school, though?
No comment.
I mean, should taxpayers be paying your money after you resigned from school?
No comment.
How come you don't want to talk, sir? Just with all due respect.
I won't even comment to that.
Following Olmsted's litany of no comments, we asked for a comment from his attorney. In a written statement, his lawyer declared, "Timothy Olmsted has never discriminated against any student. Plaintiff's allegations against Mr. Olmsted are false, and Mr. Olmsted is confident he will be completely vindicated by the true facts." What those true facts might be remain a mystery. To the children, though, what happened is all quite obvious.
Did he make you feel like you were not as important as the white kids in the class?
Children who are still dealing with the emotional ramifications. Gary Tuchman, CNN, St. Paul, Minnesota.